Travis from POSGuys.com. Today we're going over kind of an old school product. We're going over serial barcode scanners, and I have a Honeywell Orbitz here with a serial interface, and kind of covering how does this work with Windows, because most computers these days don't have serial ports anymore unless you're using a point-of-sale specific computer like an all-in-one computer. Those have built-in serial ports generally. But what you'll need for using like a tablet or a regular desktop is a USB to serial adapter, and they look something like this. There's extensions available for them as well. If it's hard to get to the back of your computer, then you can kind of run a cable. And generally these are just plug and play. When you plug them into your computer, Windows detects it as a USB device and it installs automatically. If it doesn't, then there's normally drivers available for the different types of USB to serial converters. And then part two is you have to check device manager and find out what port was created. So if you go to start menu, and this works for Windows 7, 8, 10, and then you go to control panel, just type in control panel, and then you are looking for device manager. Once that's open, you look in the port section. So under ports, common LPT, it'll map to a serial port, and there's USB serial port. So if your point of sale software or your inventory software is compatible with a serial scanner, then in the software itself, there'll be a setting where it'll ask what is the COM port for your serial scanner. You select the number, and then normally the software set up that whenever any data comes in on that COM port, then it'll send it to your point of sale software. So this is great when you don't have focus. So you can use like on-screen, touch-screen buttons. The cursor might not be in the scan barcode box, but if you scan a barcode, it still enters the data into the system. So that's really useful. If your software doesn't do that and it just has an input box, it doesn't work with serial scanners, then you need a middleware piece of software. So I'm running a piece of middleware software here called DataSnip. It's free. I just downloaded off the internet. There's a bunch of these. There's dozens of them. They're all pretty lightweight pieces of software. And so in it, there'll be a basic setup here. You pick your COM port from the list. This shows a whole bunch of COM ports. You have to know which one it is. I'm on COM 3. And then it'll be your kind of your default settings for the speed of that port. 9600N81 are the general settings that are used with everything. So if you set the scanner to default, then you're going to be using 9600N81. So use that. The other thing is, in order to get it to an automatic carriage return, you'll have to do this translate button here. So I have that checked. Sometimes, depending on your scanner, if you try to send the carriage return automatically afterwards, it won't translate correctly, and the data will transfer, but it won't hit return. So that might be a necessary step. So when the scanner's plugged in, plug it back in now, and I'll hit start redirection. And then it should work just like a regular USB scanner. So if I scan, it should go where the cursor is. And then you see the carriage return appearing automatically. So that's basically how you can use an old serial scanner with a newer system that might not have a serial port. The adapters are fairly cheap. They're under $20 for them. So if you have an older scanner, you might not necessarily need a new scanner. You can just get an adapter and use it. For more information on serial barcode scanners or to purchase, please visit us at POSGuys.com. Thanks.